This was the pot that had the flour in it. And remember, oh, look at that incredible soil. Wow. Far out. I think the worms must have come in and laid some more soil in here. Look at that. Oh, it's just beautiful. That is incredible. That's what you can get if you just leave your pot sit to fully break down. Oh, that is just magic. Couldn't ask for a better result. But I'm going to leave that there. Let's go and have a look. Put some leaves on top, keep that moist so it doesn't dry out. Let's have a look at the pot that had the protein powder in it. If I haven't shown you, any of you, how to use a lift pin, this little pin goes inside your lid. Now, it's not really for turning, but look, see, it can work. It's more for when you're propagating, so you can lift that up because it's all full of soil, pick it up like that, and then remove it without all your seeds that you're trying to grow falling over the garden. Now, this is interesting. That flower in the other one, fully decomposed, and this one is still going. We had a bit of rain in the last day or two as well. Oh, it's a completely different result. Look at that. Oh, now that is stinky when I dig it up. There's still soldier flies in there, and I can see down the bottom it's turned to soil. But that bit on the top is still going, which is really interesting. So let's go and have a look at the one that had the dry powder in it, but which has also been wet now from the rain that we've had. Can't get the grip of it. Oh, there's something blocking it. No, nothing blocking it. Oh, there we go. Now, that cardboard that was in the middle has gone. The cup is still there. That's the decomposable cup. The soldier flies are in there, and my guess is the soldier flies are still in there because of that protein powder. So it clearly takes them a long time to process that powder. And this one is stinky as well. So very, very unusual. It doesn't usually smell at all. But you can see there's still soldier flies in there chomping away. Slow though, they're slow. And you know what I'm going to do with this one? I'm going to put some more waste in on top of it. Looking for some... There's no grass clippings here. Hang on a sec. So it's interesting in both these experiments. This one had the flour and the protein powder in it and the piece of cardboard in the middle. The piece of cardboard's been eaten, but the protein powder is still there. And it's quite smelly in comparison. And the flour one, of course, disappeared completely. So I'm going to put the cup back in there. I've got some really stinky waste to put in here. I can't remember how long this has been on my sink. Oh God, look at all that bacon my son threw out. God, he's terrible. Anyway. A bit of fibrous matter in there too from those beans, and there's the leftover, but I'll just rinse that out with some water. Some wet grass clippings from the rain recently. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go back to the other protein powder one. So this is the protein powder one, but I found in the garden today, which I'd forgotten about, some wheat that I'd tried to propagate last week, and it was too hot, so it rotted. So I stuck it in this bowl, I brought it out in the garden, I completely forgot about it. Look at this stinky mess. And it's pongy, it's really pongy. But you know what? Soldier flies love fermented wheat. They just love it. So I'm going to tip this out. Oh, that's terrible. Normally, I'd be able to grab that and just pull that whole thing out in one piece. But because it's so wet, I can't do that. So I'll take the lid off. Now, this is the pot, of course, that had the protein powder in it that's taking a long time to decompose. So let's just get that water in there first. It'll be easy for me to get rid of the rest of this stinky, smelly stuff. I'm surprised the neighbours haven't complained. Because it's pretty bad. I'll just get a bit of more water to... Oh look, there's a... Even the moth didn't survive in that. So I'll get a little bit of water to flush that out. Look at the flies going crazy, they can smell it. Now stagnant water doesn't smell anywhere near as bad as that does, I don't reckon. Well, it probably does if it was left long enough. Oh, that's really taken a lot of the stink away. So I'll put this back on then. Actually, I'm going to cover it. Tip out that. Look at the flies, they love that smell. Again, look at that beautiful soil from the grass clippings and the leaves. You can't beat that. You don't have to do anything. You put that around your garden, it'll turn into soil like that if you keep it nice and moist. So let's put some more grass clippings on there. I'll just leave this here for a minute and show you the flies that land on the lid that had the smelly wheat in it. Blowies. So it's quite possible I might have transferred some maggots into here because of those blowflies, but it doesn't matter because they won't find it easy to get out. But you can see how they love rotting, smelling, stinking stuff. And now, with your pot covered, see? I'll put this over here so the flies are away. Thanks for watching.